Welcome to the Slide Getting Tech Simplified channel. And today I'm gonna be talking about setting up multi-factor authentication inside of Office 365 environments. So why do you wanna stay to the end and watch this video? I'm gonna be covering two different ways to enable MFA or multi-factor authentication inside of your Office 365 environment. So let's get this started right now. Knowledge is king. The first thing I need you to do is sign into your Office 365 admin portal. And once you get to the dashboard screen, click on active users. On the top column here, click on multi-factor authentication. And then I want you to scroll down to the user who you want to enable or disable this for. Then you can also do bulk updates if you want to do multiple users at the same time. If you're unsure when you get to this page what to do next, they have nice hyperlinks to learn about what you can do and what you can't do. And it even gives you a guide on how to do it. So for right now, I'm going to click on Slide Gittins, and I want to enable multi-factor authentication. You can also set different settings here. You can say required users to provide contact methods again if they already set it up. In this case, I have, so let's go ahead and do that. And click Close. And now what I'm going to do is let me sign out of my account and then log back in. So once you have put in your password, it's going to get to this page for more information, and it's going to force you now to go through the steps to set up MFA in your environment. First thing is they're going to tell me to, on my phone, install this application I already have, as you can see here. So let me click Next. And now, if prompted, allow notifications, add, and select work or school. So now what I can do is say add. Let me click on the plus sign on my phone. Then click on work and school. And then let me scan the actual QR code. And let me click next. Now I gotta click approve. And now you can see that I can leverage my 2020 cell phone to gain access into my account. So I'm gonna click done. And now I have successfully completed MFA inside of my environment. So let's go to the second way that you can also deploy MFA. So now let's take a look at the second option that you have to enable MFA. So we're gonna scroll down on that Office 365 admin page, and we're gonna go to Azure Active Directory. And within my dashboard, when you get to Azure Active Directory portal, we wanna click on users. When we click on users, then we wanna click on multi-factor authentication across the top. One thing you're gonna notice is it got me to the same exact place that you could have went through Office 365 admin page. Again, if you come from an Azure background, this is the way you might be more comfortable with, or if you're more comfortable with Office 365 way, it gets you to the same place, right? So we'll go about setting up the same way we did it before. Let's go into Sylvester Gittins. Let's go to enable, and let's enable multi-factor authentication. And then one thing, let's double check something. Let's imagine user settings. I'm not gonna require user settings because I already went through the setup process, but if you want that user to do it all over again, you can, but you can just hit enable and it will use the same settings. So let's go exit out of my account and then let's sign back in. So once you put the username, you're gonna put in our passcode. It's gonna ask me to approve or deny. And now I have MFA in my environment. Look how easy that was to enable cloud MFA with Office 365. Thanks for watching my video to the end. Next week, I'm gonna have a way better training. You can't believe it, right? Better than this training? Yes, I'm talking about enabling data loss prevention policies, or DLP, in Office 365, so you don't wanna miss that. So how don't you miss that? Liking, subscribing, and clicking the bell to stay notified every time I release a new video. You have to do it. I need you to do it, so make sure you do it. And in the meantime, if you got some more time, watch the other videos in my channel. The fun shouldn't stop here. This is only the beginning. So until next time, see you later.